Fashion Week in New York City draws out thousands of people to see the new trends. Well, guess what? This year, Rochester is having its first Fashion Week, and it'll benefit young women in Rochester. Newsday's Megan Backus gets a sneak peek of the event and at a design that's giving the event a lift.
Think of it as air you can wear.
It's incredible. I can't wait to see the model get into it.
Larry Moss, a Rochester origamist, helped design this eye-popping dress.
Essentially, what we're doing is making small bubbles in the balloons to form the fabric.
He's also helping the city's first Fashion Week get off the ground. Moss plans on designing a balloon wedding dress for the event. Chintiza Stern and Megan Mundy are behind Rochester Fashion Week.
They will see some really fun, interesting, off-the-cuff fashion, but then they're going to see some real mainstream fashion as well.
The women wanted to produce shows featuring local designers, but they also wanted to give back.
I was so intrigued about bringing our community together and ultimately helping the Center for Youth.
100% of the proceeds will go to the Center for Youth's Chrysalis House. There, homeless teen mothers are living and working to finish school and find jobs.
We need the money, and we'll use that money for everything from food to diapers and rent. And we know that these dollars will make it possible for those kids to stay there and be safe.
Some of the young women will get to check out Moss's wedding dress creation and other local fashion designs on the catwalk. The show runs next weekend.
You know, names that I've heard that have been thrown out at me, and to find out that they were here, it's just great to be part of the same show with them.
It's great to be able to see what it takes to make a dress and to actually wear a dress. It's wearable out of balloons.
That balloon dress took 14 hours to create. So imagine the time it will take for a whole wedding dress. You'll be able to check it out at Fashion Week starting September 30th, running through October 2nd. For more information and tickets, head to our website, rochesterhomepage.net. Megan Backus, News 8.